independent advice, independent scientific advice, and I particularly work in this unit which is called the Policy Lab, and we provide services in future-oriented explorations technology, citizen stakeholder engagement for co-creation, policy co-creation, social assessment of technology. So there's a reason for my presence here, and I really think Felix and Annette Commons' invitation to be here at least bring some ideas. I think sometimes this discussion falls in much into the technical side of it, and I think from the policy perspective, bringing a couple of social or more community-based, without community-based being only the technological development, helps a lot to push the discussion forward. And I've seen this in other projects. We're working, in fact, in one of the sister CAPS projects of Net Commons, which is Making Sense, where we really try to put that into perspective. I have a couple of ideas here. I have one or two big ones, but small ones. How breaking the spectrum bubbles, because I think this is one of the key questions right now for community networks, really impacts on universal access, or this is just, you know, you break the spectrum bubble, you have the access, and then you expect it to trickle down into universal access, but it never reaches, because just technological fix, may we call it that. Another question that I might have for community networks, and I think it's a really good community here around the table, what's the place of governance models, and if it should be given a more central role? Because we all hear it's bottom-up instead of top-down, but are community networks really developing bottom-up governance models beyond the bottom-up technology deployment and technology development, which relates how do community networks promote upskilling in the volunteers in the community? Because sometimes the idea that you can learn easily how to set up a community network, it's quite stretchy, as you all know, because you are on the ground. So how is this being factored in into how community networks get developed? How are you really supporting the volunteers or the citizens to learn how to do this in a more autonomous way? And again, which touches how community networks are promoting social inclusion and diversity. And this is a concern. It's a concern to bring what in policy you can call the more excluded or more fringe groups into the, or you, the major concern is to really set up the technical infrastructure, and then everything else will trickle down from there. I have one interesting question. In fact, I've known about community networks for a while. I think one interesting question, and maybe a provocation, is and reading a couple of your documents in the Net Commons, the idea of neutrality of the network and genericity of the network comes quite often. Maybe in some networks more than others, maybe Wi-Fi has it more than others, but across the Atlantic we are now seeing small ISPs and small bottom-up ISPs going for the no-platform strategy for some hate speech groups and some type of content. Is this a concern that community networks will have here, or will this, you know, I have no position here, so is this a concern that some networks will get to a stage which they want to discuss, or you have never considered it? On another, flipping a little bit of the question and now bring it a little bit back into the GRC, and I think I'll close it here. One of the things that we've been looking in the past year in decentralized technologies such as blockchain or bottom-up sensing with the Making Sense project is how sometimes what policy needs from community-run, community-developed and bottom-up and grassroots, and we can find a lot of names for them, technology programs, it's not only the data and the infrastructure they bring to the table. What we've been looking at, in fact, it's a project that we currently have running inside the GRCs. If the key principles of openness, of co-creation, can also be brought into the policy cycle together with the data and with the infrastructure. And this is something that we are quite keen in doing right now at the GRC. We have a big project on public engagement, and in fact we've been exploring with a lot of technology development at grassroots level, how we can bring more than infrastructure and data to the policy, how we can bring openness, co-creation, how we can bring some methodologies that you've been experimenting with your communities on the ground to build infrastructure, how we can bring that into the policy. Because this might not seem as direct for you, but I will assure there's a space for this. And also another question that always strikes my mind, because I've been working on this for more than 10 years, that sometimes we feel that we have a lot of evidence to showcase the value of community-run technology deployments. And in fact, there's a lot of technological evidence that supports that this is a really good idea, and we all believe in the high ground, in the high moral ground of having this project. But there's the other side of the policy making, and as GRC, that's something what we try to do mainly for the Commission, but sometimes also for the Parliament, try to provide a more readable and understandable evidence frame that can be easier for policymakers to extract. I know this, you know, it's not the fault might fall on both sides, but you are the community networks here. So I think this is a message that it's quite crucial for pushing the policy agenda, trying to diversify the type of evidence that is brought to the table, not only technical evidence, not only this is really good, this is like social good or civic tech, and we all use the same buzzwords and the same keywords. You know, I have way more to discuss, but I know we're short on time, so please, I'm more than available even after this to continue discussion with some of you.